Warm welcome to all this evening. Thanks for coming out on this horrible night. And a very warm welcome to you who will be listening later to the broadcast. Just as a welcome, I was just going to go through the events we've had this year. We've had plenty of events at Chailey. We had Macaulay's going off to New Zealand. That was an event for 4 months. And also at the same time, we shut the church for the whole of January because of COVID, and then we opened again with a bang on the 30th of January with Mike and his band came along and played. It was a really good opening to it. Then on February we had Big Breakfast where John Goodway spoke about his work and his evangelistic work, and it was great to hear from John. And then February we had a Mother's Day special. March, we had Mother's Day meeting where we had, I can't remember what happened in that. We gave out flowers to everyone, but we didn't have a meal because we thought everyone were going to see their mothers, like good children that they were. And then in April we had our Easter services and we had an Easter egg hunt in the garden, and it was nice weather again. And in May, we had a ploughman's lunch here, which everyone enjoyed. I think, who came to speak to that? I'm trying to remember. That was, of course, yes, the Crawleys were back, and they came and they spoke about their trip to New Zealand. Thank you for doing that, David. And then, yeah, part two to come next year, in fact, in January. And we've got a leaflet to the back about that. And then June was a great night, wasn't it, when we had the Jubilee Platinum Tea. We had the Sussex Day Fair, and our family expanded with Henry coming into the world, our latest grandson, on the 20th of June, nearly born at our house because it was a bit of a rush in the end. And then in July we had a messy barbecue. That was good. It sounds good, doesn't it? It was always messy, but Messy Church had a barbecue and it was well attended. We had the sad news of Val Eastwood dying on that day, one of our stalwarts of the past. In August, we all went on holiday because there was nothing special happening in the church, but we all met here, I'm sure. And then in September, we had the harvest service, and we had the death of the Queen. And because of the death of the Queen, we didn't have our harvest Thanksgiving meal as a mark of respect. In October, we had the China sale, which was great. How much did it make, Dave? Quite a lot of money for our friend down the road there. But anyway, quite a lot of money, which was great. There was a great outreach to the people of Chailey. And then in November, we had the craft fair and big quiz on the 19th of November. And that, again, was a great reach out to the people of Chailey. Success. And then another one of our ex-members, Hedley, died in November, greatly missed. And then December we had our Advent stories. We had a great meeting on the night. Was it the 4th of December where we had our children's story and everyone joined in? That's great. If you haven't watched that, please do online. It's fantastic. And then we had our Home from Home and all these other things in December, lots of things. So it's a happy new year for 2023. And the Lord bless you and keep you. And that's my message to you as we start. We're going to start with a hymn, looking forward now to the new year. That was last year. We're looking forward to now. And it's really good to sing this. The Getty's Marvellous, Magnificent.
Too vast and astounding to tell, forever existing in worlds above, now offered and given to all. O fountain of beauty eternal, the Father, the Spirit, the Son, sufficient and endlessly generous, magnificent, marvelous, matchless love. and marvelous, matchless love. How great, how sure his love endures forevermore. Magnificent, marvelous, matchless love. How great, how sure his love endures.
Reminder of God's magnificent love for us, and it won't change next year as it hasn't changed this year. Okay, Jan's going to come and read our reading, Psalm 127.
Unless the Lord builds the house, its builders labour in vain. Unless the Lord watches over the city, the watchmen stand guard in vain. In vain you rise early and stay up late, toiling for food to eat, for he grants sleep to those he loves. Sons are a heritage from the Lord, children a reward from him. Like arrows in the hands of a warrior are sons born in one's youth. Blessed is the man whose quiver is full of them. They will not be put to shame when they contend with their enemies in the gate.
Thank you. A reminder that God is building this church, not us. So I think we should sing this hymn 151, for I'm building a people of power. And we are powerful, even though we may be small, if we're built in the Lord's work. That's good. Something to remind us.
Make us one, Lord, in your body,
seated. Just have a word of prayer. Dear Lord, as we come to the end of this year, we know it's been a year of contrasts. Lord, we celebrated the Queen's Platinum Jubilee, and then within 2 months, she was dead, and she was in your kingdom. Lord, we do pray for the new king, King Charles. We pray that he may serve you as his mother did. Lord, we think of the turmoil of the world. We think of the disruption and the war that reminds us of the sin in this world, particularly the war in Ukraine. And we pray against the evil dictates of Putin and Russia. And we pray that the people of Ukraine may be resilient and strong and brave to resist. Lord, we know this is not, unless you step in, going to be a short war, but a war of attrition, a war of fear, a war of sorrow, and a war of loss. But Lord, we know also that you're a sovereign God and that you can overcome these problems. We do think in this country of those who are far away from their families at this time because of the war, the many families that have been disrupted from Ukraine. But Lord, we also think of the thousands that have made that perilous journey across the English Channel this year. And we are sad in heart as we feel all those that lost their lives because of that journey. Lord, we pray for wisdom for our government, our ever-changing government. We pray for stability. And above all else, we pray for wisdom from above. These times are troublesome. These times are difficult. And yet we move on, trusting in you here at Chailey Church. Thank you for the opportunities we had over Christmas to proclaim the gospel by word and deed. We thank you for the Home for Home on Christmas Day that reached out to the people of Chailey. We thank you for the fellowship that was had one with another on that day. We thank you for the hard work of Janet and David in supplying this. And Lord, we look forward to the warm hub that is starting in the middle of January. Pray that as Jan and I head this up, pray that we may be blessed with your presence here. Pray that we may be able to witness again to the people of Chailey that we're reaching out to them. But Lord, above all else, we are a church that proclaims the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ, the good news of Jesus coming to earth as a babe, living a perfect life and dying on a cross for the sins of those who trust in him, and rising again in triumph on the third day. Thank you that you did all this for us, and overarched by that is the love that you have for us. Help us as a church to love others as you loved us. That's a huge ask, Lord, but with the help of the Holy Spirit, we can do this. Lord, I want to finish with this quote from Proverbs 30, which can be our prayer for the year here at Chailey. Proverbs 30, verses 7 to 9. Two things I ask of you, Lord. Do not refuse me before I die. Keep falsehood and lies from me. Give me neither poverty nor riches, but give me only my daily bread. Otherwise, I will have too much and disown you and say, who is the Lord? Or I may become poor and steal, and so dishonour the name of my God. Amen. Isn't that beautiful? I love Proverbs, and it's a wonderful reflection of how things are. I'm going to not have guide me over that great Jehovah today, if we're going to go straight on to the sermon. So, this has been a year of change, as I said. We've had two monarchs, three prime ministers, and we've had four chancellors of the Exchequer in 4 months. Another quiz. And numerous other government posts. I won't even ask you how many. Thousands, hundreds. The Queen, as I said, celebrated her Platinum Jubilee in June, and we all celebrated the wonderful reign of our Queen. But she was dead by the 8th of September, at the ripe old age of 96. And I must say her witness was right through to the end. And those that know her said right till the end she was kneeling by her bed and praying to her Lord. War started in Ukraine on the 24th of February this year. And the world has shuddered at the consequences of this. Briefly, there was fears of a nuclear acceleration. Thankfully, and God thankfully, that these have gone down a bit, but we were always conscious that that could happen. Oil and fuel prices shot up. Gone down a little bit now, but they're still high. Food prices are the highest they've ever been. And other costs, including essential food like bread and milk. It's like that, isn't it? Now, every time you go to the supermarket, they've gone up again. These are the food's essential things. Inflation is rampant. Interest rates have risen sharply. Food banks have increased by 200% to cope with the demand. And warm hubs are opening up, including one here at the church for 3 days a week from the middle of January. If you used to look at this as a whole, quite frankly, with a few exceptions, i.e. the Lionesses winning the European Cup and their song coming second in Eurovision, which is a miracle, this has been quite a challenging and difficult year, hasn't it? So I feel even more we at Chaley Church in the next year need to look forward and rely on an unchanging God. Hebrews 13 verse 8 says, Jesus Christ is the same yesterday and today and forever. Echoing what Malachi said from the Old Testament, it's always good to put the two together. I, the Lord, do not change. It's the same yesterday, today and forever. If he's helped us yesterday, he'll help us today and he'll help us in the future. So we're assured of by a triune God that he is always the same and never ever changes. We need absolutes. We need people that we can rely on. We need an entity that we can rely on, and we can rely on God. We can trust in God. And what does that mean? It means he's always good. He's always loving. Always all-powerful. No matter how this world changes around us, we can trust in God. And that should give us confidence. That should give us a good night's sleep, shouldn't it, as Christians? This should give us confidence to go into 2023. The world needs absolutes, and God is the biggest absolute you can ever have or will have. So for people here and for those listening, please put your trust in God and not in man. There is no one else that can give us that salvation and that satisfaction. There is no one else that can raise us up when we're low. There's no one else that can give us that assurance of peace, love and joy. And that is the important thing. That's why I go on. That's why other people go on. That's why we put the effort in to talk about the Lord Jesus Christ, because it is so important. It is something to grasp. This year we've been going through many books, haven't we, Andy?
Oh, yeah, many.
And Romans is very difficult to understand, but the thing that's come out of Romans is that God is dependable, that we're all sinners, but God has saved us and given us the righteousness that is in Christ. I'm paraphrasing the first six chapters of Romans, which has never been done, I think, in 20 words before. But it's there. It's not the depth there. But it's there because what God has done. And Paul's excited about it, and I'm excited about it, because it's complete, it's utter, it's utterly reliable. And we need to trust in that God that gives us all this. He gives us such a salvation. I read this quote the other day. It said, God is like bleach. He removes stains. No more, no one else can. It's not adequate to describe God, but it is quite good, isn't it? There is a fountain filled with blood, drawn from Emmanuel's veins, and sinners plunged beneath that flood lose all their guilty stains. Written by someone who was a manic depressive, who tried to commit suicide six times, and yet he came to that conclusion. William Cowper was a troubled, disturbed man, but he knew who the Saviour was, and he knew who was preventing him from committing suicide all those times, because he knew of that fountain that was filled with blood, the Lord Jesus Christ, that could cleanse every sin, every time he went wrong. So we should pray for patience, as patience is trusting in God's timing. And that's very difficult to do sometimes, isn't it? Trusting in God's timing. We need to listen to God. We need to hear God's voice. We need to turn down the noise of the world. Do you remember I was saying about my grandson's ear defenders that blocks it all out? Sometimes we need to do that. We need to trust in God. But you say there's so much to worry about, and I've done so much that is wrong in thoughts and in deeds this year. Surely God can't forgive me. The Bible says that Satan is the greater accuser of the saints. And if that's what you're feeling, it is Satan saying that to you. Because a wise man once said, when Satan reminds you of your past, remind him of his future. He hasn't got one. It is death. And also think back to that fountain filled with blood and forward to our glorious future in Christ. And there's the comparison that we need to think. And finally, we read in Psalm 127 earlier, verse 1, unless the Lord builds the house, builders labour in vain. The challenge here is for us at Chaley Free Church, building our house, our heritage in God's will, that is individually and corporately. We are like Saul before he became Paul, fighting against God if we do it against God. And the rest of that psalm extols the blessings of a family, and we should cherish our family. I think you had 29 or something in your house at Christmas. It was a crush, but it was cherished, wasn't it? It was a wonderful time. Also, on another level, we have a family here at Chaley Free Church. We are a family together. We're a body of Christ. So let's enjoy each other's company. Encourage each other. Laugh with each other. Cry with each other. And above all else, rejoice in the Lord with each other. That's something to do, isn't it? In the coming year. I wish you all a happy and a God-centered new year. And I want to finish with this quote from Billy Graham. God is unchanging in his love. He loves you. He has a plan for your life. Don't let the newspaper headlines frighten you. God is still sovereign. He is still on the throne. Amen. Have we got time for Great Is Thy Faithfulness? Just.
2 minutes.
Heavenly Father, we're about to embark on a new beginning as we face a new year. So we ask that you would lead and direct us as we go through this new challenge. Father, will you stay close to us so that we not stray from you? You are our good shepherd and we are your sheep. So help us to keep our eyes fixed on you as we trust you in all things. Grant us provision for all that we need in order to start this new journey through the directing of your Holy Spirit. Thank you, Father. Amen.